Welcome back. You're watching The Pulse. So the world's biggest generic drug maker probably wishes it had a cure for the debt crisis in Europe. Teva's shares suffered their biggest fall in 9 months yesterday after Europe's problems held back earnings. First quarter sales rose 25%, though, to $5.1 billion. That, though, missed analyst estimates, which came in around $5.5 billion. Sales of its multiple sclerosis drug, Copaxone, also disappointed. The company derives an estimated 42% of profit from the therapy, which is set to face tougher competition when patents expire in 2014. Should you buy? Should you sell? Let's go to Tel Aviv now and speak to Ori Hershkovitz. He helps oversee $500 million of investments at Sphera Funds Management. Ori, thank you very much indeed for joining us. Hey, look, it's a big drop. Teva's got a few headaches that it's got to face, but am I a buyer after this drop?
I think it's a great buy at these prices. If you dive down into the numbers, you actually see quite a different picture. They had a one-time effect stemming from inventory reduction in the United States that really hampered sales. But if you look down to profits, even factoring in this one-time inventory effect, they were still ahead of street consensus by about 2%. If you take it out of the equations, they were way ahead of profit estimation. I think the bigger problem was in the conference call.
Walk us through what happened there then.
Jeremy Levine, the new CEO, made a statement that he does not stand behind the exiting CEO guidance for 2012. I think that investors were expecting a more firm hand behind the wheel. And when he said, "I'm not standing behind these numbers," the stock just
why,
dropped.
Why would he not be standing behind the numbers? What would be his, what's his reasoning?
That's a great question. And seeing the fact that they're running at about $6 per share running rate, and the guidance is only $5.5 per share, one would expect that he could easily beat these numbers. And another funny thing is that when people just got around to ask him this question that you just asked, the line went dead. Conference call went dead for an hour or so, and you know, the uncertainty around the what happened exactly there just hampered the stock. 5% down, over three times the average volume.
You can understand why. That's a fairly fundamental shift, and if they haven't got a good answer, you've got to be wondering why. And markets like to have certainty, and that doesn't sound like certainty. Hey, look, we're short on time, so let me just ask you a couple of other questions as well. Copaxone, if I hope I'm pronouncing that right, the MS drug. Often it's better to travel than arrive when it comes to these sort of things, or the other way around. Is the market discounting too much negativity for the patent cliff the company may face with that particular therapy?
Yes, I think at these prices, which are just around 7x earnings, there is a lot of negativity, maybe a little bit too much negativity into the stock. Obviously, in the next 3 or 4 months, we'll get a patent ruling on the 2014 patent on the drug. Markets is really focused on that issue. But I think that bringing in Jeremy Levine, who's done such a great job at replenishing pipeline at Bristol-Myers, was the right thing to do. And I have great confidence that he will do the same job, at least as well, in Teva.